According to Ronald Kasasa, the DFC head of business banking, they are looking for a group of starters involving youth with proposals and well-researched ideas. This is coupled with business plans that have the capacity to absorb and create an impact on the economy.
We've seen a group of starters comprising of so many youth, which shows that there's been an appreciation of our culture by the youth. And again, the kind of proposals they've come up with, are very attractive proposals. They are well researched, with good management structures, with good market out plans, and with good, financial planning. But just coming to seek for support from the bank, not money to start from zero. So it means that there's good appreciation of agriculture, but also the potential that is in agriculture is being appreciated, while also there is an indication of capacity building.
Most of the businesses we've been looking at today have ideas that are really new, in the sense that they've only been there since about 2021, 2018, and that's a bit of a short time for a business to run. However, there are businesses that have also invested in learning and displayed by their participation in a program like this, which means that there's a desire to grow and a willingness to do our work to grow.
The women-led businesses will receive support from the Agribusiness Development Center after it launched its business acceleration program to its partners and stakeholders last year.
Do your financials add up? Do you have proper systems that they can rely on besides you who's pitching to give them back their money's worth? But also, I found that investors look out for impact. What impact are you having on the community, on your workers? Are you offering job security? Do you hope to employ the youth? You hope to socially, as a company, do you contribute to the society?
The accelerator program was launched to enable 350 agribusinesses become self-reliant. Story by Lucius Kasoma for the news.